As a dermatologist, the number one product that I always recommend to my patients is sunscreen. It is pretty much essential for preventing skin cancer and also for preventing signs of premature aging. So today, I'm going to be going over my favorite tinted sunscreens. I'm Dr. Sam Ellis, and I'm a board-certified dermatologist. I'm here to help you understand your skin and find skincare products that work for you. If you like what you see, like this video and subscribe to my channel. So why a tinted sunscreen? I mean, you absolutely don't have to use a tinted sunscreen, but there are some added benefits. One is a lot of sunscreens contain zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. These are considered mineral or inorganic UV filters, but they can leave a white cast on the skin. By adding in tint, you can pretty much counteract some of that white cast or all of that white cast, which makes the sunscreen more universally appealing and allows people with deeper skin tones to wear the sunscreen without leaving an ashy finish or sort of like a white cast. The other thing is that tinted sunscreens contain iron oxides, and iron oxides are an important ingredient in protecting the skin against blue light, also known as high energy visible light. Blue light isn't a problem for everyone, but if you are prone to hyperpigmentation or melasma, we know that iron oxide can protect against that. So when you have tint in your sunscreen from iron oxide, you get this additional layer of protection aside from just UV ray protection. You get the blue light protection as well. And then lastly, I think tinted sunscreens just make the sunscreen application easier if you don't want to wear foundation or you want to go makeup free, but you still want a little bit of coverage. Many tinted sunscreens will afford you that so you can even out your complexion a little bit without having to rely on a second makeup step. I personally wear tinted sunscreen for all of those reasons. I would consider myself a pretty low maintenance gal, so being able to get out the door with just like tinted sunscreen and no foundation is awesome, and I love that there are some sunscreens that I can rely on to give me that little bit of coverage without having to go into a full makeup routine. Now, before we get into my favorites, I should probably just tell you a little bit about my skin in case you don't know. I tend to lean sort of dry, and then my skin tone in terms of color is pretty neutral, maybe leans slightly warm. And I think that's one of the hardest things with tinted sunscreen is finding a tint that works for you, because a lot of tinted sunscreens don't come in a ton of shades, and many have these sort of universal shades, whatever that means. That can be kind of tricky. So when I'm talking about these sunscreens, they work for my skin tone, and my level of dryness or my level of oiliness, which is not oily at all. The other thing is that when I'm picking out tinted sunscreens that I personally enjoy using, I want there to be tint, but I don't want it to be so heavily pigmented that I'm discouraged from using the proper amount of sunscreen, because the SPF that is promised on the bottle is only as good as how much sunscreen you're actually putting on. And if something's really heavily pigmented and you're just using a little bit so that it looks really natural, you're not going to get that full SPF that's stated on the sunscreen package. So I want something that has a light amount of tint so I can use the proper amount, still get the SPF, and still look really natural. All right, let's get into the products. First up, we have the Dermatology Physical Tinted Moisturizer SPF 44 Universal Tint. So like it says, it is a physical sunscreen. It has 10% zinc oxide and 5.5% titanium dioxide. This retails for about $28 for 2.1 ounces, which for a really good tinted sunscreen, that's not bad. This sunscreen is water resistant up to 80 minutes. And I think one of the things that I'm most impressed by is that even though it is a physical or mineral-based sunscreen, which oftentimes can feel a little drying and feel a little cakey on the skin, this one feels incredibly hydrating and incredibly nourishing. So much so that I think if you have oily skin or tend to get really oily over the course of the day, this will almost be too moisturizing for you. Even though this is an oil-free formula, I think a lot of people might find it too shiny if you have some baseline oil. For me though, I think it gives this very nice radiant finish to the skin. It has some pigments. You do get a little bit of coverage. It goes on sort of as a warm tone, slightly yellowish, and it does oxidize just to a slightly deeper, more warm orangey tone. But when I have any bit of self-tanner on, the color is totally fine. And because it's a pretty sheer application, even if it's not a perfect color match, it's going to blend in really well for a lot of different skin tones. Because I really like this tinted sunscreen, I have spoken spoken about it on my Instagram, and I often will get some DMs like, hey, can you compare it to the original DRMTLGY formulation tinted sunscreen, which is not physical? It has zinc oxide, but it also has octinoxate in it. So I have both of them. Tried them both a lot. The DRMTLGY original one is SPF 46, so slightly higher than the SPF 44. I would say that is a negligible difference in SPF. But I've also found that the original has a more serum-like texture. It's a lot more liquidy or more watery. And for that reason, when I put it on my skin, it just made it look a little bit more oily initially. I find that once they dry down, they're pretty dang similar, although the original also is just a little bit darker. And so because it isn't a great color match for me, I prefer the physical. The physical is also just nicer if you have really sensitive skin, if you can't tolerate octinoxate, because you don't have to worry about the chemical or organic UV filters causing sensitivity. Next up, I have the Neova Smart Skincare Silk Sheer 2.0 Photo Finish Tint. This is a broad spectrum SPF 40 sunscreen that is water resistant up to 80 minutes, and it retails for about $51 for 2.5 ounces. This is a sunscreen that came into my life about a year ago. It was recommended to me by a friend who is also a board certified dermatologist. And I was just like, where has this sunscreen been all of my life? It is just such an easy application for a tinted sunscreen. It feels incredibly lightweight on the skin, and it just blends so seamlessly. Even when I'm tan, even when I'm really pale, I find the color works very well. And I think that's because it is not heavily tinted. It's nice too, because it works as a makeup primer. So although I don't wear foundation on a daily basis, if I do want to put foundation on over it, it sits super nicely and it helps my foundation last a lot longer. This sunscreen is a hybrid sunscreen, meaning that it uses both mineral and chemical filters, or inorganic and organic UV filters. And in this case, this one has octinoxate, titanium dioxide, and zinc oxide. And what I find about hybrid sunscreens in general is they just can be very cosmetically elegant. You don't have to include as much tint in the sunscreen oftentimes, because you're not trying to counteract as much of a white cast. And you can make the formula just a little bit more lightweight, because pure titanium and zinc oxide sunscreens have the tendency to feel a little bit thicker and a little bit heavier on the skin. Out of the bottle, this sunscreen has sort of a warm peachy tint, but because it is not heavily pigmented, I think it could be used on a wide variety of skin tones and still blend really, really well. It feels like a lightweight lotion, so it's not as thick and creamy as some of the other tinted sunscreens that I'm going to talk about today. And I don't say this about a lot of sunscreens, but I feel like it could work well for both oily and dry skin. I think for oily skin, it's gonna set up nicely on the skin, and because it works as a primer as well, it's gonna help with a little bit of that shine control. And then for dry skin, you could layer it over a moisturizer if you really need more oomph in terms of hydrating your skin. But when I use this alone, I don't find that my skin dries out over the course of the day either. So this really has a lot of universal appeal as a sunscreen. Next up, we have one of the sunscreens that was featured in, well, the only sunscreen actually that was featured in my Holy Grail skincare original YouTube video. And that is the original Colorescience Sun Forgettable Total Protection Face Shield SPF 50 PA++++. I love this sunscreen. This retails for about $39 for 1.8 fluid ounces, and in my opinion, it is worth every penny. This is a mineral sunscreen, and it exclusively uses 12% zinc oxide to block those UV rays. It also has some proprietary Colorescience ingredients, like their infrared protection technology, as well as their own blend of antioxidants. When I first saw this sunscreen out of the bottle, I thought, there's no way this is going to work for me, because it is a very light, peachy pink, cool toned tinted sunscreen. That being said, it does not deposit a whole lot of color on the skin, so it is not highly pigmented, and it just leaves this really beautiful, radiant finish on the skin that makes you look a little bit glowy and just healthier. That being said, if you have medium to deep skin tone, I have a feeling this will read a little bit ashy or just leave a little bit of a white cast, so there might be better tinted sunscreen options if you have a deeper skin tone. I mentioned this when I talked about this sunscreen in my Holy Grail skincare products video, but I'll say it here too, that this is not the most lightweight sunscreen that you could ever wear, but if you take the 20 to 30 seconds to really work it into your skin, it is so worth it. It leaves this beautiful finish. It wears well under makeup if you want to, but if you just wear it on its own, it's also so, so lovely. I'm really about to double down here on Colorescience because I have another favorite tinted sunscreen that Colorescience makes, and that is their newer release, which is their Sun Forgettable Total Protection Face Shield Flex. And this sunscreen is a little bit different. It is still a pure mineral sunscreen. It is still SPF 50. It is PA++++, so four pluses instead of three like the original, but it has a lot more coverage. And I'll get more into the coverage of it here in a second, but it has a lot of the same Colorescience goodies that the other sunscreen has. It has niacinamide, which is smoothing and soothing and helps with sebum and oil control. It has the proprietary infrared technology to protect against infrared radiation. It has its own unique blend of antioxidants to add additional UV radiation protection. So lots of goodness in that sunscreen, in addition to just being so beautiful on the skin. Like I mentioned, the Flex Colorescience sunscreens have a lot more coverage. So when you go in and put them on, they can almost provide this light to medium style foundation coverage, depending on how much you're using or how much you're trying to build up the pigment. Straight out of the bottle, they look completely white. So it's kind of like, what's going on here? But as you work it into the skin, there are pigment spheres within the sunscreen that burst and deposit pigment. So as you work it, you'll start to see the color start to show up, and you know to stop blending it when the color matches your skin. This sunscreen comes in four shades: fair, medium, tan, and deep. And if you go onto my Instagram, I have a reel where I swatch out all of the colors for you. I'm always sort of between the fair and medium, and something that's really cool about this sunscreen is that you can mix them together. Normally, I don't recommend mixing sunscreens, but because they have the same formulation and Colorescience has given the okay on this, you can mix the colors to get something that perfectly matches your skin tone. Now on to my final favorite of the day, which is the EltaMD UV Clear Tinted version. So the original EltaMD UV Clear was probably the first sunscreen I ever fell in love with, my first love. But for whatever reason, over the past year, it has started to pill up a little bit on my skin. I don't know if that's because they changed the formula or it's because it's the way I layer it now with my other products. But for whatever reason, the tinted version of the UV Clear does not do that for me. It does not pill up, and it is amazing. I don't know why I had waited so long to try it, but it is so fabulous. It is the most lightweight sunscreen that I've mentioned today. It has almost a serum-like texture when you apply it, and it just feels so good when you're putting it on. You're like, you know that this is nourishing your skin because it is delicious. Here we have another hybrid sunscreen, meaning that it has both chemical and mineral filters. In this case, this one has 9% zinc oxide and 7.5% octinoxate, which probably is what helps it feel so lightweight on the skin. EltaMD also sort of touts this as a great sunscreen for rosacea prone or acne prone skin, probably because of the inclusion of niacinamide in there, which helps with oil control and can be soothing and help with barrier protection and sort of barrier restoration if your skin has been agitated or irritated in any type of way. And I think also it just feels really lightweight. So if you're worried about your sunscreen feeling heavy or clogging your pores, this might be a really nice one to start with. The finish on this is just slightly dewy, and the tint is similar to all of the EltaMD tinted sunscreens except for their UV physical, which is a lot cooler and more pink. This one is a little bit warmer, but it doesn't feel as heavily pigmented as some of their other tinted sunscreens. For example, when I compare it to the EltaMD UV Elements, that one tends to read a little bit warmer and a little bit orangier on my skin, and I think that's just because it probably has a little bit more pigment in it. For whatever reason, this one still matches my skin really well, and it doesn't pull as warm. I think the only people this wouldn't really work well for are if you have very, very dry skin. Because it is that watery serum-like texture, you may want to layer a moisturizer on underneath it. And if you have very, very fair skin or very cool toned skin, it is a little bit on the warm side. It is a little more deeply pigmented, and so it might not be a great color match. But otherwise, the EltaMD UV Clear tinted version is phenomenal, and I think so many people would love it. I do have a few honorable mentions in terms of tinted sunscreen that are like almost perfect, and I think would be perfect for a lot of people, but it just doesn't jive with my skin for one reason or another. But I do want to give people whose skin might be a little bit different than mine some other options. So the first up is the Alastin Skincare Hydra Tint Pro Mineral. I actually am obsessed with this sunscreen. Like, it is so beautiful on the skin. It is a pure mineral sunscreen. It has 8.9% titanium dioxide and 3.4% zinc oxide. This just feels so creamy on the skin, so luscious. It's like a joy to put on, and it gives you this beautiful, hydrated, dewy glow. It's just, unless I have the deepest self-tanner on that I possibly could, it's too dark for me. But oh my gosh, in terms of finish, like if they made this in one shade lighter, it would probably be like the holiest holy grail of tinted sunscreens for me. It is amazing. This bad boy is SPF 36. It is water resistant up to 40 minutes. It is chock full of awesome antioxidants to just boost the UV protection and the infrared protection that it already offers. I feel like if you have skin that is darker than mine, this could be amazing for you. Also, because it is so hydrating, if you tend to have drier skin or just more mature skin, this is also just an amazing option. And then my other honorable mention is the Australian Gold Botanical Sunscreen Tinted Face SPF 50 BB Cream. This comes in two shades, a fair to light and then a light to medium, I wanna say. No, medium to tan. This is the only drugstore sunscreen I'm mentioning, I'm sorry. So incredibly affordable. You get 3 ounces in the tube, which is phenomenal. This has sort of a moussey whipped texture to it. So very fun to apply, very easy to apply. And it dries down pretty much matte. So for people who get oily over the course of the day or would describe their skin type as oily, I think this is a great option for them. The only reason I don't reach for it over and over is because it is a little orangey and a little bit warm on my skin, especially if I don't have a fake tan going on. So it's not something I reach for all the time. But when I do have a fake tan on, I do like to go for it. And it has been awesome to wear under masks because it dries down so well. It doesn't transfer as much. So it just has that little added wearability benefit. So there you have it. That is a roundup of some of my all-time favorite tinted sunscreens. If you have a favorite tinted sunscreen that I did not mention, put it in the comments below. Also, if you have any additional questions about the sunscreens I talked about, I always go through my comments and I'm happy to answer any related questions. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, and I will see you next time. Bye.